They make up one of the world's oldest fraternal organizations, and in Philadelphia, they gather in a landmark building right next to City Hall. They are the Freemasons, and for centuries, they have been surrounded by secrecy and rumor. But tonight, Action News has a rare look inside their doors. Action News reporter Dan Quayer is live outside the Grand Lodge with this fascinating story. Dan?
How are you, Jim? They are known for their elaborate temples and arcane symbols. As you say, their Masonic Grand Lodge in Center City is a national historical icon. But what the Freemasons may be best known for among the general public is secrecy.
One brother to another. I'm a Master Mason.
Our responsibility is that we are part of members of the greatest fraternity in the history of the world.
For the very first time, Action News cameras have been allowed inside to record a ritual that has been hidden for centuries. Mason Thomas Hopkins is about to be inducted as District Deputy Grand Master.
I will keep, support, maintain, and abide by all the ancient usages, customs, and landmarks of the fraternity.
You will kiss the Holy Bible and arise. I now invest you with the collar to which is pendant the jewel of your office.
Hopkins also is given the apron that carries the seal of his office.
Brother Thomas Hopkins, District Deputy Grand Master, I congratulate you.
It is a ceremony that seems fairly innocuous, but to understand, you have to go back 3,000 years to a Masonic legend that traces their origins to the biblical ancient temple of King Solomon, the place where the Ten Commandments were believed to have been kept. Solomon's master builder was a stonemason named Hiram Habith, a master mason who, according to legend, was murdered by his three apprentices who wanted to know the secret password and handshake that would identify one as a master mason.
We had these modes of recognition. That was like a union card back then.
And so it is that the murder of Hiram Habith is reenacted in ritual form as part of the process of becoming a master mason. It speaks of a lost word, the word of life, key to all secrets, a word that cannot be spoken in public.
And that's the password. And that's simply to recognize from one mason to another, to confirm one brother to another, that yes, I'm a master mason.
It is a universal brotherhood, and so we can communicate as Freemasons universally with symbols and allegory.
By 1700, they evolved into a progressive gentlemen's club, no longer limited to practicing stonemasons. They would now call themselves symbolic Freemasons, carrying on the ancient traditions of Hiram Habith. Their most famous symbol, the square and compass, embraced by the letter G for God. Their all-seeing eye atop the pyramid can even be found on the dollar bill.
And one of the underlying tenets of Freemasonry is we try to take a good man and to make him better.
Through the years, the Masons' charitable works around the world have been immeasurable.
But if you were to go up the street just a little bit, you would see the Shriners Hospital for Children. We'd have the Knights Templar with the Eye Foundation. You could go into our Scottish Rite to where you could see the work that we do for schizophrenia and the children. We have learning centers for our children who have a dyslexia.
To be a Mason, you must not violate the laws of God, man, or country. Although women are barred from membership, they invite any male believer in a supreme being to join them, regardless of politics, religion, and race. But that was not always the case. The Prince Hall Masons on North Broad Street were formed when African Americans couldn't join white lodges.
Not until the mid to late 1900s that we have seen a shift.
The Prince Hall Masons of Philadelphia most notably rally around the Stop the Violence campaign. Many believe the fraternity puts its members in key positions to help control the U.S. government.
To me, that's the stuff that movies are made out of. The conspiracist would just never go to rest.
But many of our founding fathers, including George Washington and Ben Franklin, were Freemasons. Philadelphia's last four mayors were all Masons. Mayor Wilson Good, Governor Ed Rendell, Mayor Street, and current Mayor Michael Nutter. But even with all these influential Masons, membership is down. To boost it, they want everyone to know you don't have to be invited to be a Mason.
I cannot ask you to be a Mason. That desire must be yours to be a Mason.
Having tackled the secretive Catholic conservative group Opus Dei, Da Vinci Code author Dan Brown is currently working on another book, The Solomon Key, which focuses on the Freemasons. We have more excerpts of the Grand Master Stephen Gardner's interview, and we will have a slideshow with pictures along with information about the Freemasons on our webpage at 6abc.com. At the Grand Masonic Lodge in Center City, Philadelphia, Dan Quayer, Channel 6, Action News.
Thank you, Dan. You anticipated what I was just about to say. More about the Freemasons on our website at 6abc.com, and you can watch some extra clips from Dan's interview with the Grand Master. More about the Freemasons at our website. Interesting story.